Yo, what's poppin', everybody? Man, Woothehousecat, HipHopDiaries.com, 1.9 million subscribers and banging. You know how I do. Excuse me while I drink some Rebel. Mm. Everybody that knows me knows that I have a top 10 favorite. And every interview I do, we get into that top 10 favorite. And the man sitting to my right happens to really be in my top 10 all-time new school. I don't want to say all-time, but top 10 current hip-hop artists today, man. Fred the Godson. We just got interrupted, man. The camera, you know how I do. You know my shit always gets fucked up. Fred was just telling us he's Afro-American. He's from the Bronx.
Yeah.
What part of the Bronx you from?
South Bronx. I was born on 171st College.
Okay.
I was raised on 156 Fox, right back, Kelly, Longwood, Southern Boulevard, St. Okay. Joe's.
And now, yeah. since the money, you were telling me, since the money's right, you moved to the Thrives next section.
Yeah.
And we were having that conversation about how you got over to the Thrives next section.
Yeah, in the Bronx, when you run to a little bit of money, you know, it's either Riverdale or Thrives next.
And I lived in the Riverdale section. And you moved to the other side. To the Thrives next section.
Yeah.
How did you get started in hip hop, man?
Like being in the hood, you always car go by blasting it through the system, like, you know, the radio, whatever. It's six of us. I'm the oldest out of six, actually.
You got six brothers and sisters? Or five?
Five, yeah.
Plus you were six?
Yeah, yeah.
Older? Younger?
I'm the oldest.
Okay.
Oldest out of six. We was raised on Fox, 156, in a shelter, actually. You know, we got burned down on 131st in college, so we lived in a shelter. I was the oldest, and, you know, we ain't have no money. You know, at that time, my father was on drugs, but he's clean now, like, you know.
Peace to dad. We're looking for that.
You know, like back then it was hard, you know. My mom's just young, she's 24, six of us. And
wow, 24 was 6 years old?
Yeah, and my father was on drugs, we was in the shelter. So it was crazy, you know what I'm saying? So money was twisted, but you know, we had the radio. You know, that's the only time, you know.
So let me ask you, before you continue, what is mom's, I'm sure she's proud of you at this point.
Yeah.
To come from six kids in a shelter in the Bronx, and you to have gone on to do what you do, how does she feel about that?
Does she love it?
Does she? She's a supporter? Love.
Yeah, because, you know, growing up with me, it was crazy because I'm the oldest, but like out of all the kids, I'm like the one with the most ailments. I have asthma, diabetes, high blood pressure, and kidney failure. So
damn, right?
It's like, that's why
don't fuck with this Red Bull, man.
You trying to give me the 40 ounce Red Bull.
Anybody know who's seen Fred the Godson come and ask for a Red Bull? Cut him off.
That's what I was asking. Like, yo, how the hell you take all that shit out? You bulletproof, man.
Damn, Fred.
Yeah, man.
How's your health right now?
Yeah, but I'm cool. You know, I'm used to it. So as long as I take my medicine,
all right. Watch what you got to eat and all that stuff.
Yeah, you know. You know, so I know God's been good, so I've been rocking. You know, that's how actually story. I'm just gonna throw the story out. My name used to just be Fred. It wasn't like the Godson, whatever. So I started rap like a little late, like 18, 19. I started like really writing rhymes and shit. So I remember I went to my doctor. Mm-hmm. They had gave me some tickets because I was gonna do this on talent show. And I was like, listen, I'm about to rap. I got a show tonight. And she like, no, your levels is bad.
Your health level.
Yeah, my asthma. Yeah. I can't do it. Right. Like, I run like a full court, like two games the most. And it's
so you out there running full courts?
Used to.
Okay.
Used to.
Okay.
Not no more.
Right.
No, sir.
Right. I'm sure you got a basketball court in the backyard. All rappers, that's the first thing they do. They get a court. Even if they can't play, they get a court.
I ain't got that. I mean, my love for that is gone. I watch it though. I told her I had a show, and she said, I don't do it, your levels is bad. I'm like, nah, but I've been practicing. And I knew why she was saying it, because I catch asthma attack for everything.
Right.
I'm like, nah, but I've been practicing in the mirror, I'm practicing in my room, I'm good. She like, I don't believe it. So she actually came to the show.
To listen, to watch you.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
And
the doctor came to the show.
I did my thing. And the crowd was loving me. I didn't win. I came in like third place.
Wait,
but that was my
show. Stop. Who'd you come in third place to?
Nah, that was my first show. I was shaky. I never rhymed on stage.
Yeah, but ever. Even when you can't, even when you can't rhyme, you're better than 99% of the things. And that's the truth. I don't know if everybody had to hear Fred spit. You're a metaphor monster. But anyway, go ahead, finish.
So I came in third, but the crowd, they was loving me.
I still want to know one or two though.
I don't
you don't remember that. That is significant. Yeah, you don't even remember them.
Nah, but they did their thing though. But okay. I got off the stage and everybody was like, yo, how long? I was like, nah, I just thought it's my first show. They was going crazy. Like,
how long was this?
This is like probably over 10 years ago.
Okay.
So they going crazy over it. And my doctor was in the back and she was like, oh my God, I can't believe it. You really did your thing and you good. It's like God was looking over you. It's like your godson.
And I just and that's it. Where it came from?
It was just Fred.
Godson? And I just okay, and you adopted the godson.
Yeah.
Any of your sisters and brothers, the other five, are they into rap or they moved on to the professional?
Yeah, about the baby. My brother Izzo, Fat Boy Izzo, he's the youngest out of us, and he just started his rapping thing now.
Okay.
You know, he just came out of jail. He's just there for quick year, but he's rocking. He started before he went in. When he came out, he's rocking. We just had a show in Philly last night.
Okay.
Yeah, he's doing his thing. My other brother.
Up under you, or he's moved on to do his own thing, or
no,
is
he's
he with you?
Me.
He's under you.
Me, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What does TBM stand for?
Talking about money.
I never knew that. I've seen the TBM logo.
Yeah.
You never changed TBM.
Yeah.
I never knew. Talking about money.
Yeah.
How many people are with you besides yourself?
It's just like a gang of us. It's like, it's more like a gang.
But
you know what I'm saying? But we got rap. Like, shout out to my man, Mr. Papers. That's Lil Kim baby father.
Okay.
As well. Shout out to them.
Okay.
And shout out to Ben Vito. 5,000.
Right, he just jumped on the shots. Anyway, we're gonna get that.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I gotta. When you say
TBM,
I gotta
shout
out my niggas.
Okay,
Fat Boy Izzo.
Any of them have stuff out or coming out?
Yeah. Fat Boy Izzo got his LP is out.
Okay.
His EP is out. He did an EP.
Okay.
And he's working on a mixtape now.
Okay.
And Mr. Papers, he has work out now.
Okay.
And him and Papers got a Mr. Papers and Kim and Kevin Gates got like a
but you lead the way.
Coming up. Yeah.
You like the general. Nah, you like the general.
Yeah, we all.
No, that you being humble about it. But you the general. Don't. I don't know what I'm trying to say, but your bars is ridiculous.
Yeah.
No disrespect to them, but I know you gotta lead the way. You opening the door for everybody else to come through.
Yeah.
And that's what's up. That's definitely a good thing. How do you feel about the state of Bronx hip hop now? I mean, there's not a lot of brothers coming out of the Bronx right now.
Nah, the crazy thing is, I know it's a lot of talent, and it's, you know, it's a crazy thing. It's just that people get older, and then life happens. Like, I know rappers that I knew rappers that was real good that I looked up to myself.
Mm-hmm.
But as time go on, they get girlfriends and
life,
girls get pregnant,
kids,
and then you know this music thing takes a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I must have spent like $300,000 before I made $1.
Really?
You know, just studios and things like that.
So
like,
you strictly started from zero on your own.
Yeah.
Finance yourself.
Yeah, nobody.
There was a rumor. Now correct me if I'm wrong. No, I don't know. This was rumor that you were signed to Carmelo Anthony one time. Was it Carmelo?
Nah. I never signed nobody.
Was that a rumor though?
Yeah.
Or did I only hear that? I only heard that.
I never heard that. Carmelo's my man.
He never heard that. I heard you were signed
to
a basketball.
Shout out,
Carmelo Lala. But I heard you were signed to a basketball.
Never. Everything you ever seen Fred with. Fred had himself.
Strictly independent.
Strictly me.
For everybody that thinks this can't be done across the country, this man right here is living proof that you can go from 0 to 60 in not 3 seconds, probably about 10 seconds. It's not easy. It takes a lot of work and a lot of money.
It's a lot of patience.
Now that we're talking about that, what would you recommend somebody do that's sitting there? I have 1.9 million subscribers and a lot of people gonna watch this.
Yeah.
What would you tell them to do? To get started, like you did.
Let me, when I say myself, let me rephrase a little bit of that. Let me give salute to my team, my man Zoe, Free Dre, and shout out to my man Sean Price.
Mom and Dad. Oh yeah, rest in peace.
No, not Sean Price.
Sean Price.
And I hope nothing happens to him.
No, nah.
Shout out Sean Price, rest in peace.
Yeah,
that's a homie. And Sean Price did a like. He helped me out.
Okay.
Like, really called certain calls. You know, he had the relationships with DJs and everything. So
to get you put on.
Yeah.
But what would you recommend somebody that's up on the come up do to get started? Because you have the blueprint. You've done it. You're doing it.
Yeah, but you know what it is? It's easy to say it, but it's the means to get the money. you know, it's just hard. It's easy for me to say, yeah, we spend that much money, but it's like the next question everybody's gonna ask.
How do I get
them? How did you get the money? It's, listen, it's, some people do things they're not supposed to be doing.
Right.
Some people, they survive it. Some people, they don't.
Right.
There's people doing years in jail. Like, y'all know the story. Y'all know what it is. And some people's lucky to get through the cracks. You know what I'm saying? But however you can do it, you can go slowly. You could be working. You can put your money to the side. I know a lot of people that work.
Right.
They put their money to the side. They don't got to be afraid to Godson when they buy their own studio.
Right.
Get they can just... They save up their money, get their checks, and get their sessions.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? As the time go on, you get cool with the studio owner, then they'll throw a couple hours in for free, and you work like that. But just try to do it yourself. I mean, like, just think, yeah, there's rappers that's out there. They want to be rappers. They want to do their thing, and they like, I don't really got the money to do that. But then their lifestyle is expensive. Like, they'll spend $1,500 on shoes, on sneakers. You know what I'm saying?
And take ones and boom up in there and
yeah. You know what I'm saying? Where you can, if you really pace yourself,
right,
and just be
down,
like, I ain't gotta do that. You know what I'm saying? You gotta do all that. Just take that money.
You know, I never see you in any blog, new magazine, paper, doing any dumb shit with your money.
I don't believe in that. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't never seen you take a stack of money and throw it in the air ever.
Let me tell you something. And everybody that know me knows this. My wife, my baby mother, love her to death.
Mm-hmm.
I met her in a strip club.
Okay.
She was one of the top dancers.
Right.
And she'll tell you, this nigga ain't making no money. And I swear to you.
She'll say that as she comes in.
I swear to God. She will tell you, I ain't make nothing rain, nothing. I just talked to her, we sat in a room.
To this day, ain't nothing rain.
It's nothing crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like, probably throw a couple of hundred, but I know niggas.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Niggas
like,
pick it up and...
It's no way. You know what it is? Like I told you, you know what it is? I guess it's... Like I told you before in the beginning, I come from a shelter
right. With
six of us.
Right.
I know what it
You're
is.
You're a pretty humble dude. Now that I'm sitting here talking to you, you're mad humble.
Yeah, you know, it comes with... It's just where I come from. It's like...
Yeah, but you're the same dude. Did, when I walked in the door, greeted me, greeted Giselle, you
yeah.
the same dude sitting here.
No, I know that. No, I'm saying, no, you're absolutely right. I'm just saying, how can I put it? Like, I talk to a lot of these niggas.
Right.
Like, for instance, I ain't saying nobody's name. I talk to niggas. So, I'm with my man, and we talking, we outside, chopping it up, and this kid came and said, yo, I can get a picture.
And Duke said no.
He was like, nah, not right now, shorty. And I'm looking at him, and he walked off. I didn't want to scold my
man
in front of the kid. But when he turned out, I said, yo, my nigga, what you mean not right now? You not over here every day. He don't see you.
Right.
This might be the last time he ever gets to see you
right.
in person.
Facts.
You can't tell this not right now. Like, so when is a good time? You know what I'm saying? Like, and that right there, he's just like, nah, you know what I'm saying? Like, can't be taking that many, like, why?
Why not?
He's like, no, because it's going to look like they can access
you at any time?
Your homie, man. Like, and now you know what? And then when he said that, I ran into a lot of people, a lot of rappers, a lot of niggas that everybody look up to, and they say the same thing. And I'm like, I'm never like that.
So you're a regular dude?
People see, I go to grocery stores in other hoods, and I be in different places, like even today, when I was in the Heights, and I'm in the store, I'm getting an icy on the corner behind three old ladies.
So you're a regular dude.
Yeah, because that's the way I move.
But
my peoples get mad at me. They like, yo, my nigga, what are you doing? Like, niggas will call me like, yo, what's up with Fred, man? I see this nigga. This nigga's in the park with all these niggas. And I'm like, yo, I'm a regular nigga.
I'm
you know
a regular
what I'm saying?
Nigga.
I can't move like that, you know?
But you know what? I respected your game when I walked in the door, but I respect you 10 times more now that you said that. Than I did when I walked in the door.
That's love. It's
good
real shit. True
good,
shit.
But good. Stay like that, man. And most of you niggas, 99% of you niggas, and I said it, he didn't. Fred ain't even talking to me. 99% of you niggas can't even spit as good as him. So how y'all on some shit and he's not, I don't know what the fuck y'all talking about. If he's humble, you niggas need to humble up too, man. There's only a handful of niggas on my left hand that are better than him. Trust me when I tell you that. If he's humble, you niggas can humble up too. Next time a kid come up to you and want an autograph, ain't gotta be an adult like me, but a kid, come on, man. Sign that fucking autograph, man, and keep it moving. What do you think of the state of hip-hop today in general? Like, there's a lot of... Let me ask you this. What do you think about, because they don't play you on the radio now.
Nah, I gotta fight for that.
That's what I was going to say.
You know what it is? It's like you said, it's the state of the music. But you can't play a Fred the Godson.
You're better than 99% of the niggas out there.
And that's the problem.
How is that a problem?
That's the problem for the radio.
How is that a problem for radio?
Alright, for instance, there's they have a certain thing that go on, right? That's called, you know, the BET cipher.
Yeah.
Everybody was saying, you know, that Fred's supposed to be in this. And now every year I'm as close to being on it.
Why haven't they asked you? So you're gonna take me all down on the streets?
It's just
politics.
Yes, exactly.
It's how was it politics when you better than 99% of the niggas?
A lot of these dudes, a lot of these people from these labels and everything, they'll get they artists to be on there. So whether they pay or whatever, they get their own thing. So just say you got your own, joint.
Right.
So you paying, say you pay a certain amount of money, right. You have three artists under you to be in the cipher. So they gonna display these skills. So how about if the nigga come over and be like, yo, listen, yo, we gonna throw Fred the Godson right in, you gonna be like, nah, I'm not paying y'all money so this nigga come in and get his own shit out.
But I always thought it was about niggas that actually spit, had skills.
That's what I thought.
So what you're saying is, it's not really about niggas that have skills, it's about niggas that have money.
It's about, you know, they play what they want to play on the radio. You would think when it comes to a cypher, you want to hear the niggas that
well, Fred, New cypher. York radio? You the hottest, one of the hottest niggas. Wait, let me rephrase. This is probably the hottest nigga coming out of New York right now. No disrespect to French. Rest in peace, Chinks. Hov is on some Hov stuff.
Yeah.
You probably the hottest nigga not signed in the city of New York right now. And this is me saying this. How can I not put Fred the God in a cypher?
You know, it's crazy. It is what it is, you know what I'm saying? There's only but so much, you know, I don't cry about shit and I just keep working. But it's like with that, like the people, like when you see when it comes on, like that's when all my shit just lights up. Nick's like, yo, Fred, what the fuck? We boycotting this shit. Yo, you supposed to be on this shit. Yo, you supposed to kill this
every
shit.
Every year. Snow the product. You know Snow? Snow the product.
Nah.
See, she's in one of the ciphers. Snow the product, I got a hold of Snow a long time ago when she first was coming out. She's a Mexican chick out of Texas. She's a beast. And she was on a BET cipher. And I forgot who was on there with her, but she did a BET cipher. And when I saw the cipher, in fact, I was watching it last night or the night before again, I said, how come Fred is not in the cipher? So, is it in the works?
Yeah, it's in the works. It's definitely in the works.
Next year, the year after?
I'm trying, man. It's definitely in the works.
It can't be based on skills.
It can't be.
It's not. And this is obvious.
Can't do it.
This is obvious. So how do you feel about New York City radio not, and they get criticized a lot for this, not supporting New York City artists the way they should?
It's about, I think it's disgusting. You know, it's when you hear, I would never guess in a million years, and I don't want nobody to get this shit fucked up. Just know I'm a fan first. Fuck Fred the Godson, fuck what Fred the Godson doing. Take me out of the equation.
Right.
Make believe I never rap. I was just a fan. I'm just standing on the outside looking at it.
Right.
I would never guess in a million years that New York radio would sound like this. You know, that I would turn it on and I would hear what I'm hearing. Like, nobody. You know, just to think, like, Nas, when he made Illmatic, mm-hmm. was 19, 20 years old,
mm-hmm.
when he made Illmatic. If the same 19-year-old Nas was right now, 19, 20-year-old Nas, mm-hmm. and he made Illmatic, they will say, this ain't it. This album's not
so
it.
So what you're saying is, and I take responsibility for it, the radio's been taking over my bullshit.
Yeah, I mean, it's with what they playing, you hear it, and it's like, it's nothing. Like with me, when I rhyme, like, I'm representing for the Bronx as the birthplace of hip-hop.
Right.
I'm representing for New York, and I always, always want it to make sense, even if I'm sharpening a person's brain.
Right.
I want to, when I rhyme, I want y'all to say, I know why he's rapping. I know why he deserves a spot. I know why he make money off this. It's just like being in the NBA. It's like, we know a million people that play ball,
mm-hmm.
but 1%, 2% of those people go to the NBA.
But you earned your position as a spitter.
Yeah.
There aren't, and you can probably put on your right hand how many niggas are better than you.
Yeah.
As a fan, I'm sure you're not only an artist, but you're a fan of the art.
Yeah, I'm also a fan first.
A fan first. So on your right hand, maybe you add a sixth one, you can probably count really how many niggas are better than you.
Yeah.
And there's not many.
And that's because, and I'm a big fan first. And like it's like some people that I put ahead of me, being that I'm a fan.
Who you put ahead of you?
I put
being a fan, not being friend. Put yourself out the equation.
I put Jay, Nas, Big,
Pump. Old Jay, new Jay.
Same Jay to me.
But same
Jay
to you?
Old Jay's crazy.
Old Jay's crazy.
But you know, I mean, we can't take new Jay, talk about new Jay, because the dude is just that much. He got so much money. You gotta see his surroundings. A person that has that much money most of the time. Let me just say this. Jay-Z is gonna be the richest rapper ever.
Think so?
Nobody's ever gonna rhyme like the way he rhymes and have that much money.
Eminem?
Yeah. Eminem is a different kind of sandwich.
But
M's crazy, yeah. But I mean, I'm talking about as far as like Jay's money. Like him and his girl together is like over $1 billion,
of course.
So for him to be rapping like that, like he's rhyming like that, and he'll be 46 in December.
Mm-hmm.
He's really considered to be like, when you look at L, shout out to my nigga L.
Mm-hmm.
So you look at L, and you look at Rakim. Shout out to Rakim too. That's my nigga. They consider them old school.
Right.
And Jay-Z's like around the same age, if not probably older than them.
Right.
And if Jay drops something now, the world stops.
Why do you think that is, though? Do you think you're better than Jay at this point? Fred the God today, Jigga today, who's better? I'm putting you on the spot.
Yeah, I can't.
You can't say that?
I can't.
All right, then I'm going to say that. And I'm a whole fan. I'm a whole fan, but I'm going to call Fred. I'm going to say Fred all day. You still, again, one of the sickest, and I'm sure there's a lot of niggas gonna watch this say, yo, stop riding Fred's dick. Ain't even about that. What's good is good. If it's good is good, yeah. If it's bad is bad. I call it as I see it.
You know, but I'm, you know, if you had, I think if you was to ask Jay, Jay would tell you I'm supposed to be.
Why? Why are you supposed to?
I'm supposed to be better than him now.
Why?
Because he done put so much in the game, he did everything. It's like saying, like, Dr. J, in his last couple of years, and when John comes in, Dr. J did everything you could put. I put the blueprint out there for you.
So you're saying you're right where you're supposed to be?
Yeah, because I'm like, who knows? Who knows if, I can't tell you if Fred the God, 46 years old, in his 40s, and him and his girl combined, worth $1 billion, will be able to still do what that man is doing. I think that shit is crazy because it's, if you never knew Jay, like I know people, like young kids, that don't listen, that never heard Reasonable Doubt. They just know the new Jay.
New Jay.
So they be asking me like, what's the big deal? Why y'all always?
Well, the big deal is Rockefeller Records, digging the archives.
Yeah, that's what I tell them all the time. I say, listen, they like, nah, he's nice. And I'm like, for you to really appreciate the whole
thing. Right. You gotta listen to his original shit. Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. It's like the Rolling Stones today versus the Rolling Stones 30 years ago.
Yeah.
Different. So who's in your top five? Pun? Big?
Jay, Big. Jay, Biggie, Pun.
Everybody gives me those same five dudes. Everybody. If you watch some of my interviews, I get the same five dudes all the time.
It has to be that. I think it has to be that.
And where do you place yourself? Now put yourself back in the equation. Where do you place yourself amongst the top rappers today?
I never felt like it's my job to rate. I mean, for rappers today?
Yeah, rappers today.
I don't think nobody fucks with me.
And you know what? I'm gonna have to agree with that. At least in my top five, because Eminem is still spitting.
No,
he's still a beast.
I don't put Eminem in this category.
All right.
Eminem is with Jay and him.
Okay.
He's in the
Royce.
Yeah, he's Eminem. Jay.
That goes
let's,
back.
Let's do this. Jay, Biggie, Pun, Nas, Eminem. We put them
on a different place.
We make Statue of Liberties out of them.
Okay. Add it. Forget them. What everybody else that's left? Anybody. Anytime. Anybody. You never went to that battle rapping.
Well, I come from that.
Do you? You come from that? You battle rap?
I come from that. That's what I used to do, but not on camera.
Okay.
You know, when I first started, mm-hmm. I was battling. Mm-hmm. I used to do that all day. Mm-hmm. It's just like, yo, shout out to my brother Charlie Clips. That's my man. I think he's the best battle rapper out now.
Okay.
And there's people that'll argue with me, but I'll hold him top, you know, and he'll, every interview he'll say, I never lost a battle ever.
Okay.
Except to Fred the Godson.
So you come from that battle rap era.
Yeah.
And then you flipped
the battle
it.
All day.
You
yeah.
flipped it and turned it into what you do now.
Yeah.
And you're probably one of those red dudes. No, I there's probably other ones, if I stop and thought about it, that have made a good living off of being unsigned.
Yeah.
That's a secret to that.
Yeah.
That's an art.
It's an art. I'll tell you, it's a gift, because if you try this, like I said, you gotta have patience, gotta learn how to talk to people. It's you know, thank God that I got this gift he gave me. Like, you know, some people say they got a gift, they just say it, but I know I had a gift, because I couldn't, when I first started rapping, I used to write, mm-hmm. and I could say the words by reading them. But whenever I try to practice in the beginning, mm-hmm. I couldn't say three sentences because of my asthma was so bad. Mm-hmm. So as I got better writing out of nowhere.
You think your asthma contributes to how you spit?
Yeah, of course.
Not being able to.
All of that happened. I learned that because of my asthma. So when you hear, that's me catching my breath.
Is that what that is?
Yes. And you,
I hear that on every one of your records.
Yeah, that's my.
Catching your breath.
Yeah, and it's crazy because I remember one time, my first feature ever, this kid came in the studio, and back then I'll just listen to the record, and if I want to get on it, I'll get on it. It was all love.
Mm-hmm.
Then one time he came, and he's like, yo, I need you to get on this record for me. And I'm like, I'm tired, man. Just leave it here. I'll listen to it. And if I decide to do it, I'll do it. He said, nah, man, but I got like 600-700 for you. And I was just like, huh? And nobody I never made no money, ever. Remember, I told you that's $300,000. And I'm like, wait, you're going to pay me the round? He was like, yeah, man, crazy, yo. And then I was like, yo, that was like, oh, that happened, one of the best
things. He was in it.
What?
At what point, I don't want to cut you off, but at what point did you realize how good you really are? You ever step back and look in the mirror, look at yourself, out of body experience, and look at Fred the Godson in the mirror?
You know, when I realized it, and it came where, and this is not taking nothing from the big homie, just salute to him for giving me a chance and asking me to do a record with him.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Jada Kiss.
Okay. Shout out to Jada, man.
Yeah,
I love Jada.
I gotta put him in that thing too.
Okay.
Statue.
Yeah.
We don't fuck with that.
Yeah, nah. He's legendary, Jada.
Different. He asked me to do a record for him. And we did Toast to That. And I did the record, and once the record came out, because that was Jada, and that's everybody, he's in everybody's top.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I do music, and I just looked at it as an honor. I'm a fan first, like I say, mm-hmm. so doing a record with him, I'm starstruck.
Right.
You know, so when they hit the record, everybody was hitting me. Like, yo, that's crazy. And I'm like, what? He's like, you did it. And I'm like, I did what?
He's
like,
you made it.
Nobody ever got Jada Kiss on the record. You aired them out. Well, I'm like, aired them out? What do you mean? He's like, yo, you beat them. That's the way the streets.
Right.
No, everybody.
I know.
And I'm like, nah, man, like, it's different styles. I mean, he took one route, and y'all know me. I say some slick shit here and there, you know what I'm saying? Like, nah. Like, not being too humble, nigga, I'm telling you. And I'm like, no, this wreck, like.
What's the wreck?
And it's called Toast to That.
Did you know I'm going to go? Did I ever heard that? I'm not sure if I heard that. I might have heard that.
And then, you know, to this right now, white dudes stopped me 2 days ago. They stopped me outside and said, yo, Toast to that verse, one of the best verses of rap all time.
How did Jada feel about that?
Jada told me, yo, I went crazy on.
Do rappers catch feelings when they feel some type of way when another nigga verse is better than theirs?
A lot of them. That's why sometimes the record don't go down.
Because they feeling that this man's better than me, so I ain't.
Yeah, nigga, like, I'm not gonna do a record. It's a lot of people, I ain't saying no names, and I ain't do a record with because of that.
Because your verse is better than this?
Listen, I'm not saying nobody's name.
Nobody's name?
They know who they is.
I don't know who they are.
I done had calls where I'm supposed to do a record with certain people,
right.
And them niggas will call me and be like,
nah, I can't do it.
Listen, homie, And I salute them because they kept it all the way a million. Some niggas would just say, nah, I gotta do mad shit, I'm mad busy. This nigga kept it all the way.
Dumb it down?
Nah, the nigga told me.
Dumb it down.
I'm writing my album. I'm writing my album. And I can't. Everything, all my best shit, I gotta put in my album. I can't even play with you like that, my nigga. He said, I swear to God, man. Yo, your shit is too crazy. Like, I can't
dumb
even, I can't dance with you like that.
Dumb
no friend, we can't, I can't do the record, my nigga. I said, yo, I appreciate it, man. Like, it's all love. He said, yo, friend, and I'm talking for a lot of niggas, man. Niggas ain't gonna, I'm telling you, I'm gonna keep it 100 and tell you what it is. Like, niggas ain't gonna wanna do no joints with you, man. You can't be saying all that crazy shit.
Would you ever put somebody on a record that you feel is better than you?
All the time.
Like an M?
Yes.
Hov, if he's calling you right now.
Yes.
Let's get on.
Let's dance, because you know what it is? I know what I bring. So even a lot of times when I do records with the best niggas, anybody that ever did a record with Fred the Godson, they'll tell you, Fred did his verse first and sent it to me. Like, a lot of niggas don't do that.
Right.
If you can beat it, nigga.
Right.
But as long as, when I listen back, I say, I did my best. And
do you actually look at what a nigga does, or you just do your verse and move on to the next thing?
I just do what I do.
And pass it
off?
I just know
I do a good job. You know what I'm saying? I know I do a good job. I know when I put out shit, it's not whack. You know what I'm saying? And I know how I go. I know there's nobody right now that say better shit than me.
Nah,
I can flip anything.
Nah, that's not. Yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah,
I'll say a metaphor, I'll get crazy.
Yeah, yeah,
and then, you know, I know what I do. You know what I'm saying? So if you can do, if you can beat it, then this shit's gonna be a fucking crazy ass record.
You don't feel no type of way about it?
I don't. I want you to beat it. I want to look at a nigga and be like, God damn.
Have you ever did that with anybody? Fell back and said, had to rewind that so I could hear that again. You ever did that? To somebody else?
A couple of times.
What's any name?
I did that shit with Joel Ortiz on my mixtape. Right,
hopefully, that's my next interview, man.
That's my nigga.
Joel Ortiz, we're trying to get to him. Hopefully,
yeah,
that's what he's talking to him next.
Yeah, that's not.
Well, I guess that's a done deal. But
Joel Ortiz, you next, nigga.
Yeah, but you rewinded his shit,
yeah.
And he's in my top five, too.
Yo,
niggas bless me.
Listen.
Joel Ortiz, you, and niggas be like, get the fuck out of here.
Nah, them niggas haters, whoever say that. That nigga.
Whoever said that never listened to your joint.
Yeah.
Or his joint.
Yeah.
Cause y'all can spit. I don't know why you ain't get down to Slaughterhouse. It would have been ridiculous. It'd have been game over. Niggas, y'all just don't even go to the Grammys. Don't even, you ain't no BET Awards. Them niggas would have owned hip hop. Y'all would have owned hip hop.
Yeah.
It'd have been a game over. Did I ever approach you?
Nah, I always had a freestyle. I'm the fifth member of Slaughterhouse. Like, it's just, I admire them dudes from Royce. The Buttons, the Crooked, Joel, that's the homie.
If they asked you to join the group, would you?
Of course.
Yeah,
I love hip hop.
Pick up the phone.
I love hip hop. You know, anything that's good hip hop and niggas is going off, man, I'm all the way with it, man.
What do you think about the Rick Rosses?
I fuck with Ross.
You like Ross?
Fuck.
Do you think, do you fuck with Ross, the lyricist or Ross? I don't want to say the actor.
Ross, he's crazy. He's from Miami.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And this nigga, you never heard a Miami rapper spit like that. Like this nigga spits like he's from New York.
No, I haven't.
And then he got that Miami shit with him when he does that, think I'm Big Meech. Then he got the shit with.
I love that song. That was my favorite Ross song,
yeah,
by the way.
Yeah.
That shit was crazy.
He got those, and then he got the shit where he's spitting. Like the Maybach music shit.
What do you think about the Meeks?
I fuck with the homie.
I love me. I'm a Meek fan. Yeah, I'm a Meek fan.
That's the homie. That's my 2011. Freshman classmate.
Meek?
Cover.
Nicki, fuck with
her? Yeah, Nicki's one of the best. Huh?
Drake?
Oh, yeah.
Fuck with Drake?
You know what? I'm not gonna lie to you, man. Niggas might say this some dick ride shit.
Why I gotta be dick riding, though? Because you say a nigga is
this
good.
Is because that's what niggas be doing. Like, yo,
so I'm gonna be riding Fred dick.
Drake dick. Nah. I'm just saying, because this nigga is still rapping. Mm-hmm. That nigga might be in one of them statues, man. That nigga that good, man. I'm telling you, like, no matter what niggas say, who writes what, or with this nigga, like, out of all rappers, mm-hmm. we all get busy. Mm-hmm. I ain't never seen no nigga in my life do
what Drake
done. Like, if If I go to you and say, yo, you heard that new Drake song? Mm-hmm. That could be five different records.
Oh yeah.
You don't know
yeah.
what kind of record it could oh, be. It yeah. could be him going off, him singing, rapping at the end, him rapping, singing in the middle, him bouncing, him doing some rap. You don't know what it could be.
So, head to head, Drake, Fred the God, who's better?
Oh,
I'm gonna put you on the spot. Bar for bar, right here. No holds barred. Fred the God, Drake.
Nah. You can't fuck with me bar for bar, but that nigga's crazy. I'm a big fan. Drake's like my favorite.
He's like your favorite rapper right now.
Right now, he's one of my favorites.
Really? You're gonna catch a lot of heat for that, man, because a lot of niggas give Drake shit. Say he's garbage.
It's no way.
Well, you and me on the same page. This nigga
no
good
way
and nigga
be
good.
Garbage.
He's good. I agree.
It's no way.
He's worth $145 million, so he can't be that bad.
Yeah, no way. That nigga's crazy.
So, who would you say has influenced you on the come up? What rappers were you listening to? The M's? The J's? What's your biggest influence? Do you pattern your style after anybody, or are you just all original?
I think my style is original, but you know what I think? I think it's just... I took from all of them,
okay,
and it just came in one style. You know what I'm saying? Like, Big Pun had to be the most influential, only because
on you.
I was on me, only because I was in the Bronx and I seen him.
Okay,
you know, like I seen him. Like I remember when my father worked in the tunnel, mm-hmm. and Fat Joe was there. Mm-hmm. You know, so I used to get all the CDs, the posters and everything, because they used to give them out at the tunnel. My father come bring it to me, hang them up on the wall. So I remember Fat Joe being there, he from the Bronx, used to always see him. So these dudes was like superheroes to me because I see him on TV, then I seen him in the street.
Mm-hmm.
So father came out and said, yo, how Fat Joe do? He said, yo, he killed it with Joe.
Huh?
This nigga brought out some other fat Puerto Rican nigga, this nigga went crazy. I was like, another fat Puerto Rican, and he said, yo. I said, he was better than Joe. He said, yo, my nigga.
Facts.
Crazy. I'm
he
like,
was. He was.
Nah. And this big dude come out, walking in.
Pun.
And he was like, yo, that's Big Pun. I remember my father saying his name, and I'm looking. And they was like, his man was like, yo, spit something real quick. And he spit like, probably like 16 bars. And I never heard no shit like that in my life. And
it was
that
crazy.
Shit,
I didn't have the privilege.
It left me
speechless.
Speechless. And I'm like, yo, and then gradually I seen him on TV doing that, and I Ain't a Player, then doing this, doing that, and then I was just like, yo, this nigga's crazy.
Let's move to the rap thing to the left for a second. Talk to me about Fred the God the Father. I know you have a beautiful
oh, yeah.
girl, Sadie.
Sadie, and
she's just as famous as you on Instagram.
Yeah, they fuck
with. Everybody knows Sadie.
Everybody.
So people know Sadie that don't know you.
Yeah.
You Sadie's father.
Yeah. So, then people go up to me and they like,
aren't you Sadie's
son? Where's Sadie?
That's like Steve Curry. Steve Curry's daughter. What was her name? I forgot her. When she was in the playoffs, he had her on the table. She became more famous than Steve Curry
she,
for like
she was bopping.
So you got Sadie and your wife was pregnant.
Yeah.
Boy or girl?
It's a girl.
Congratulations.
She came out.
What's her name?
Sophia.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
You gonna try for another one?
Nah, it's over. Yeah. I'll try for the boy.
Yeah, I was gonna say, one more.
No way.
Boy.
Listen, my man had 8 girls, and the 9th kid was the boy. You tried every year.
So
it's not happening.
Not happening.
I seen with 6 kids. No way.
So what kind of father are you? Well, wait. Yeah. Let me back that up. You're not in the same position that your mom was, so you can't say that. You've been blessed to be able to do what you do to...
No, I know.
So you can't say that?
No, I can't say that.
Right.
But bottom line, I don't want 6 kids running around.
That's different.
Yeah, that's like
totally
crazy.
Different. What kind of father are you? You look every time I see you, because the Hip Hop Diaries fathers on Instagram. You always with your daughter.
Yeah.
Shouting out your daughter, taking the head, taking the dad.
Yeah.
So that's a big part of your life.
Yeah. Me and my wife. She's like the best mom ever.
Okay.
Like, I never seen a lady take care of kids the way
your wife does.
The only person I seen do it better than her was my mother.
Right.
Because I seen her maneuver with 6 kids, father on drugs, and she's still
holding it down.
But I never seen it. I never seen nothing like that. So with me, like, even though my father was a part of our life all day, even
right.
now,
right.
I don't, like, as I got older, I realized, like, I didn't blame him for being on drugs. That shit snuck up. The dude, that shit can sneak up on anybody. You know what I'm saying?
Snuck up on me.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So I don't blame him. So when he wasn't high, he was always there.
Mm-hmm.
And when he got high, he's just another dude, and he's looking for the next high, but that's because he was high. You know, I don't fault him for that, you know? So I try to be like the way he was.
You know what I'm saying? You go to do the school thing?
Oh yeah.
Take what grade is it? Kindergarten?
She just went to kindergarten. She go
out Wednesday. She go this Wednesday.
Wednesday. No, she first started time? 3 weeks ago. She goes to charter school.
Oh, okay.
She goes right over here on 49th.
You take her to school?
Right now my wife, she wake up, she take her, and then I got stepson. He's 16, and he goes to school all the way down in the village.
He picks up?
In the morning.
Okay.
She gets up, she drives my daughter to this school. Mm-hmm. Gotta be here at 7:30.
Then take her son?
Down there, but then I stay with the baby.
So you babysit?
Yeah.
You gonna do the homework with Sadie and everything? You gonna do the coloring?
Yeah, of course.
The first grade, second grade.
She's like advanced. You know what I'm saying?
What happens if she tells you down the line, Dad, I wanna rap?
She already raps. We play around.
Okay, what happens if
she wants to be serious? Like I say crazy and she go baby, lady. Like she does all the work. She rhymes all the work.
And if she wants to be serious one day?
It is what it is. She can do it.
Okay. And your other daughter's just born. Yeah. You're not gonna do the son.
Nah, so it's two girls. I tried, man.
All right. Moving right along, man. Talk to me about your latest project. The last one that I heard dropped on Dat Piff was Contraband.
No, Fatboy Fresh.
Fatboy Fresh. Forgive me. Yeah. And I have that too on my phone.
Yeah.
What's the latest one you just put out?
Well, Contraband 2 is coming out first week.
Didn't you have one Contraband?
Yeah.
That was which one? What was the order? Fatboy Fresh was first?
No, Contraband was first.
That's what I thought.
And then Fatboy Fresh. And that was Contraband 2.
When does that drop?
That drops October.
Okay.
That's always a collaboration with me and the Heatmakers.
Heatmakers, Arsonist?
Yeah.
Okay. I tried to get an interview with them, and I couldn't get that done.
Well, you can do that. This is Arsonist.
Yo, I'm just going to holler at Fred whenever I want to interview. I'm going to be your Fred.
Ooh, oh, okay. No, that's you can't wait to do that.
Let's get it.
Yeah.
Let's get it. So,
you could have been here right now.
Busy.
Yeah.
Contraband 2.
Yeah.
When does that come out? October?
Yeah, October.
Who's anybody on that besides you? Any collabs?
Yeah, I got Maino on there.
Okay, shout out to Maino, man, bro.
Got Votto, Joel
Votto,
Ortiz.
Votto, Harlem, Joel Ortiz.
Kevin Gates.
Okay.
Jim Jones.
Okay.
AR Ad, okay. Philly, Doc Low.
So you got a bunch of people.
Oh, yeah. I could have had more than that.
What's your favorite? How many mixtapes you got today?
What? Pink Bronx, Armageddon, City of God, Culture Band, Fatboy Fresh. Goldo, Fred and Ego.
Eight. One more, two more. Contraband 2's coming out?
Yeah, that'll be seven.
Seven, eight.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
What's your favorite?
Me?
You gotta have a favorite. What's your favorite Fred the God track? Your favorite?
My favorite? Yeah. I don't know.
You drive down the street bumping your own shit, or you bump somebody else's shit?
I don't really like to hear myself that much.
You don't listen to, you won't put on a Fred the God track?
Let me see. I listen to myself sometimes, not as much as people would think I do.
Okay, so it's every blue.
You know, yeah, it's like sometimes I'll throw it on. Most of the time my friends are throwing on.
Okay.
Besides me, but I got a couple of tracks, but like I liked, it's records that y'all probably never heard that, the ones that, They're so crazy that niggas be like, yo, my nigga, they're never gonna get this.
Did you put them out?
No.
Are they coming out?
They might.
Or they in the archives?
They in the archives, they might.
How many songs do you think you've done in general? Because we know that every song, everything an artist writes and records, they don't put out.
It has to be like 500-600.
Joints that you've written in total?
Mm-hmm.
Are you gonna ever release all of them? Or are they gonna be like the Tupac missing tapes when Fred gets to be 70? And they start releasing the joints.
I have enough joints. I have a lot, you know, and I ghostwrite for a lot of rappers.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Who do you ghostwrite for? You don't want to be nosy.
I can't.
They don't. Nah, I guess you can. No. Well, they just said Drake had a ghostwriter, but eventually it comes out, man. I mean, eventually down the line.
So it'll never come out on my end.
Nah.
Listen. Funny story.
I didn't know that, though.
Yeah. Funny story. This dude, right? He had a problem with another rapper.
Mm-hmm.
He hit me. Yo.
Write me a rhyme.
I need you to air this nigga out. All right, cool. So, I write the rhyme, lay it down. Damn, they're killing the other nigga. So he hears it, he like, yo, it's over. So I'm like, yo, listen. Instead of making it a hip hop war, you can utilize this. send him the record.
Tell him to jump on.
Tell him Gmail, send him the record, and tell him, because he disrespected him on the internet. So tell him to apologize to you. He has a day to apologize, or you're going to release this record and kill him. So I said, when he apologizes to you, he's going to come to the senses, and then y'all can do a record together. He's like, nah. I said, you'll believe me, it'll work out better for you. Hit him. Nigga, next day, I forget, I tell him, I see the apology. I'm laughing. So the dude, my man calls me and goes, yo, the nigga apologized, everything good. So publishing company calls me. The other dude's publishing. Mm-hmm. I go down there. So he's like, yo, he told me the only one that's made for the job that can handle some shit. I said, what happened? He said, yo, one of our artists got disrespected. And they told me to call you. And I said, what you mean disrespected? They played a diss that I wrote for the other nigga. And I'm like this. Oh, this nigga went crazy. He said it like this.
Not knowing that you wrote it.
So he said, how much it's gonna cost.
So you writing in your verse like for both sides?
I'm thinking in a journal like this. Yo, I am about to air myself out.
So you
out.
Wrote a verse for you,
Yo, I'm about to air myself out.
And collect a check on both sides.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like this, yo, this shit is crazy. So I was like, yo, all right. But then it's crazy in my mind because the dude told the other nigga it was squash. So my other nigga don't even know.
And you ain't want to ride around.
Huh?
You ain't want to ride around. It was squashed.
Yeah, D, I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's nothing to do with me. Like, I'm just writing it here. Y'all do what y'all want. So I'm not going to tell him the nigga call me, and I'm not going to say that. So I'm like, yo. So they was like, yo, Fred, just think about the number. Are we going to call you tomorrow? And I'm like, all right. So later on that night, nigga called the original dude I rode around for called my phone. He's like, yo, Fred, man, I told you. Niggas ain't seeing me, man. This nigga can't come back from this. But I said, I don't know, my nigga. You never know, nigga. Niggas might have something up to sleep.
Do they know to this day?
Nah, but the other dude called it off. All right. They wound up doing the racket.
So you was going to wind up battling against yourself and get paid for it. I ain't mad at you for that.
That's crazy.
That's what's up. That's what's up.
That's why you can't tell. Because you just never know.
How many people you think you ghostwrite for? You ain't got to tell me their names. I mean, but how many people you think you...
Like 20.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So there's 20 people out there right now.
Yeah.
That are spitting your lyrics.
Yeah.
What I know, if I listen to your words, if I listen to them spit it,
yeah.
Cause your word plays original.
Yeah.
It's hard to not.
You know
your word.
I'm gonna give them. I'll give them some shit, but I always tell niggas I could give you some shit that you want, but you know, if I give you that Fred the Godson shit that Fred the Godson says, mm-hmm. you're gonna have to uphold with. You're gonna have to always do it like that.
Right. Oh yeah, yeah. You can't fall back on some bullshit. Come out like, with this, and then you suck
you gotta
tomorrow.
You got to really ask, you know what you're asking me for.
Right.
I can give you that Fred the Godson fire, yo. I can give you what
some
you say.
Shit.
I can give you what you do, mm-hmm. but make it a little bit better where a nigga just be like, oh, this shit is crazy. This thing went off on
it. So dumb it down a little bit.
Yeah.
I ain't mad at you. So you got the album dropping. Any concerts, any appearances, any shows coming up?
I always got shows. They putting together like two tours for me.
Okay.
I'm in talks with, I might go on tour with, I don't want to say the name, but yeah, there's a couple of joints coming up.
All right, tours?
Yeah.
You gonna announce the dates anytime soon?
Yeah, whenever I get them back. I gotta make sure everything be solidified before I tell fans with, cause they'll watch your shit and then as soon as the shit come out, my shit get hit up, DMs and everything. Like, yo, what's the date?
Damn.
And I'm like, damn, the homie Woo already put the shit out.
Yeah, nah, I would never do that. I put it out when you hit Giselle and say, yo, drop it. All right, well, anything down the line, any acting, any movies, any TV?
They want me to do that shit, man. I mean, I'm Tunnel Vision. Like, I do, I'm just focused on what I'm focused on. Yeah.
How long you think you're gonna spit for?
I don't know, I might do this shit forever.
Think so? Like, you think you ever get tired of it? Some dudes get tired. Jigga said he's tired of it.
He should be.
Why?
I can talk right now because.
But you don't know how you
feel. Who knows? Like I said,
if my wife
is together worth $1 billion, I might say fuck this shit.
But you don't do don't this. Why you don't do this for the money.
No, but you do it for the money later. Like it's love.
Nah, you
but
know what?
You do it for the love, but you know what it comes with.
I think money's just a byproduct of what you do and doing.
It is because this is what I do.
Right.
You know, so I know. Say my bills is like $7,500 a month. I know that quota gotta be made. Right. I have the kids, my daughters. You know, and they like certain things, and shit has to be paid, shit has to be made. So, and this is what I do. It's not like if this shit is going wrong, I'm gonna go get a job for a quick.
So if you wasn't doing this, what would you be doing?
I don't know. You probably don't want to know.
Nah. Nah, I don't. I tell you, I'm clean, man. I don't do those things no more. we don't do that no more.
We might be having his interview. Behind that glass.
Yeah.
Be like the show, man. And like I said, shit got fucked up right after the interview, nigga.
We ain't trying to do that, man. Anyway, you know what? We can sit here and go on for hours, man. I can sit here and talk to Fred for hours. Maybe we'll do a Fred too. That's up to Fred.
Listen, y'all. For the record, I fuck with the homie. This is the longest interview I ever did. Everybody that know me know I answered a couple of questions. And then I start whispering after like 5 to 6 minutes ago, my nigga, listen, you wild. Like, you know what I'm saying? But I didn't even know we was rocking. It felt like we wasn't even on camera. I forgot we was on camera. Yeah, that's how you know the homie know what he doing.
Thank you. I appreciate
so, Joel, you already know Austin is next. You know, I'm going to try to call them guys, get everything popping.
Appreciate that. Yeah, gotcha. Anybody you want to shout out again?
Shout out my family. Shout out my TBM.
Mom, Dad.
Okay.
Yeah, of course.
Mom, Dad, Florida.
Oh, my what part of Florida? My father's from Florida.
In Jacksonville.
We just came back from Jacksonville, man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we was in Jacksonville about 3 weeks ago. About a month ago.
Oh, okay.
You ever been?
Yeah.
It's quiet, though. It's urban.
Yeah.
It's nothing but woods. My pops just built a house like 5 minutes from Jacksonville. What the fuck you doing there?
Like, they live with my, like, my father moved there right when they built this gated community? Big community. And everything, where he lives at doesn't look like Jacksonville.
Okay.
But it's still Jacksonville. Boring as fuck. You know
boring
what I'm saying?
Boring as fuck.
It's like God damn.
That's what I said. God damn. Exactly. God
like,
damn.
Like, why the hell would you do that? Like,
right.
We in the, like.
What do
he,
I do?
Then my, took, so my mom's going to go wherever you want to go. He's like, yo, listen, we going to Jacksonville. I'm like.
They happy?
Yeah, they happy.
They like it down there?
They love it.
All right, that's all that matters, man. That's all that matters.
But I know my mom's. She comes up here too much. I know. I'm like, your mom, you don't like that.
I think pops wants to live down here. Like my pops.
Yeah.
They the ones that want to live down there. Mom, they want to come back up here.
You know what it is? My father's a flamboyant dude. You know what I'm saying? So he knows when he's up here, he just spends too much money. It's too much shit to do.
It's nothing to do in Jackson.
No, so
pack of cigarettes, like $2.
Yeah. Everything is. You know.
Shout out to everybody in Jacksonville.
Shout out to Jacksonville, Florida.
Yeah, anyway.
Man.
Shout out to everybody who's shouting out for
you know, shout out TBM team. Shout out the whole. Old fan, rest in peace, Don. Shout out Black or Don. BX, man. Golda.
All right, here's what I'm going to do.
Coming.
Before I shut it down, you know how I do, and with him, I don't have to do this, but I always ask everybody I interview, and I've interviewed a bunch of people, to drop a quick 16 so they know niggas can really spit. You ain't got to do that.
I'll do it.
But
being that you ain't here toast to that, I'll do the toast to that verse for you.
Facts.
Okay? Alright. Toast to the street life. This is how we eat, right? Strip posh, crisp posh, gotta keep the heat tight. Toast to the connect. Cheers to the cheap price. Toast to those two foul, avoiding the three strikes. New range, the cash we took. I threw shoes on the sport, it got athlete's foot. The guard flashed the gems. I nicknamed your girl Kim, cause every time the car dashed, she in. Yeah, we used to scrape the plates, Brillo. Had the head swinging back and forth, Willow. Cops tried to ban me from the court. Billow, Riley, still with his girl, but he knows she ain't a dime. I can see that sell you like shit. And those are just dimes. I can see they sell you like shit. Fred the God, Jada Kiss, was close to that. Now let's toast to that. Golda, holla.
Yo, Woothehousecat, man. I want to thank you for your 5 minutes, my brother.
Hola.
I greatly appreciate it.
Peace.
Woothehousecat, man. Fred the God, HipHopDiaries.com, 1.9 million. You know, you can catch me on Instagram, The Hip Hop Diaries, Twitter, Hip Hop Diaries. Shout out to G Rainer behind the scenes, man. We gotta go. You all right? Peace.
What are you looking at?